Chopper-reed here. Now, I get a lot of letters from people asking me for advice, right? Fucking imagine that. A bit of bloody advice from Uncle Chopper. Hello. But anyway, I don't have a bloody clue what to do. But I thought, you know, just like Keithy George, I'll give it a fucking stab, you know what I mean? Anyway, here we go. First bloody letter is from Daniel, who's from Queensland, and he says, Dear Chopper. Hello, Danny. Hi, mate. I'm 35 years old, and I have a lot of trouble meeting women. Oh, fuck, Danny, that's no good, is it, mate? I'll tell you what you might have to do, mate. You might have to fucking harden up, all right? Stop crying like a bloody girl and, for fuck's sake, grow a moustache. All righty. This one's from Shanice, 26, and she's from bloody Canberra. She writes, Dear Chopper, my long-time boyfriend has just been sent to jail for 2 years. He wants me to wait for him until he gets out, but 2 years seems like a long time. What should I do? Well, Shanice, something you may find a little bit bloody comforting in this situation is to realise that your boyfriend is going to get pounded in the bloody every night in the fucking shower. And the only thing that's going to get him through it is the thought that in 2 years when he gets out, he's going to get to do something refreshingly fucking heterosexual with you. So if you want something to do for a couple of years, grow a fucking moustache. And this one is from... Hang on, this is from fucking Neville Bartos. This will be good, won't it? Here we go. Dear Chopper, when you shot me, I thought that was rude. Very rude. I'm sick of you coming over to apologise and then shooting me. So I have moved house and I'm not going to tell you where I live. Oh, Nev, have a fucking sook about it, mate. If you don't want anybody knowing where you live, don't put your fucking return address on the envelope. Oh, I'm sorry, Nev, I didn't mean that, mate. I'll just bloody pop around and apologise. Anyway, I'm fucking Chopper. They're me fucking letters.